All right. Okay. Welcome. How y'all doing today? Good. It's nice to have a full house. I'm glad that you found your way to the New Orleans Jazz Museum. So again, welcome. On behalf of New Orleans Jazz National Historical Park, we are so delighted to have this partnership with the New Orleans Jazz Museum to put together programs that cater to our mission. Our mission of our park is to instill a public appreciation for New Orleans jazz music, the culture, and the history. And we do so by having programs that share education and hopefully enlighten you and entertain you. And so on Thursdays, we normally have our piano hours, but we are moving towards this artist hour on Thursdays. And we have a wonderful jazz band today that we will highlight. So the Secret Six is a jazz band that specializes in New Orleans traditional jazz music. They specialize in stomps, blues, rags, no frill, and not jazz. And so they are also celebrating the 100th year anniversary of King Joe King Oliver's Creole jazz band. And many people may not know about King Joe Oliver, but he was a predecessor of Louis Armstrong. And so the music that the Secret Six will play today is heavily rooted in New Orleans trad jazz. And so I want you to help me introduce the Secret Six Jazz Band. Welcome them up. Also, I forgot to mention, please silence your cell phone so that you don't disturb any of your neighbors or the band. And at the end of the show, please come up and get one of their CDs or just tip the band. All right, they'll take it away.
Hello, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here today with you all. We want to start by saying thank you to the New Orleans Jazz Museum for having us. Folks, today you're in for a special treat. We'll be playing the music of Joe King Oliver and his Creole Jazz Band. 100 years ago today, on April 6th, 1923, Joe Oliver took his Creole Jazz Band to record at the Jennett Studios in Richmond, Indiana. In addition to Oliver on cornet, the band included his protege, Louis Armstrong, on second cornet, Baby Dodds on drums, Johnny Dodds on clarinet, Lil Hardin on piano, Henry Dutre on trombone, and Bill Johnson on double bass. Recordings made by this group in 1923 demonstrated the New Orleans style of collective improvisation and brought it to a larger audience. This is our centennial tribute to Joe King Oliver and his Creole Jazz Band.
Bye.
Oh, Sweet Mama.
Thank you so much. We are the Secret Six Jazz Band. Thank you so much again for having us today. And yesterday, 100 years ago, is a special day. So they changed the world. The King Oliver and his Creole Jazz Band recorded this kind of music 100 years ago. And we are so happy to play this kind of music for you guys today.
Yeah.
And today we play all of King Oliver's tune, and the next tune is a Chimes Blues. And personally, I heard this tune for my first time. It's not King Oliver's recording, but Sweet Emma Barrett and her Preservation Hall Jazz Band, they recorded in 1964. And Percy Humphrey, he's a trumpet player, he played the Louis Armstrong's solo as a melody on that tune. That's why, so I think this melody is a Louis Armstrong solo, but I mix up, so I listen to King Oliver's original one. So actually, they have another melody, so we play the original King Oliver's one today for you guys. And that's why, so the revival band, like 16th in New Orleans, they learned the song from someone who learned the song from someone. Who learned the song somewhere? You know, and Louis Armstrong, he actually played his solo in improvise, but his solo is so amazing, and his solo just survived, you know, in the decade. And you can hear the Louis Armstrong's original solo. Zach actually played the Louis Armstrong solo, right? The next tune is the Chimes Blues.
Pressure's on.
Yeah. I want to say thank you so much to the King Oliver and the Louis Armstrong. They are the reason why we can play this kind of music today. So I hope 100 years later today, so someone still play this kind of music in New Orleans, right?
Yeah.
The next tune is called the Chimes Blues. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you so much, everybody. This next one is called the Sobbin' Blues. Thank you. That was one of our favorites called Mabel's Dream. This next one is called the Jazzin' Babies Blues. As a mentor to Louis Armstrong in New Orleans, Joe Oliver taught young Louis and gave him his job in Kid Ory's band when he went to Chicago. A few years later, Oliver summoned him to Chicago to join his Creole jazz band. Louis remembered Oliver as Papa Joe and considered him his idol and inspiration. In his autobiography, Satchmo, My Life in New Orleans, Armstrong wrote, "It was my ambition to play as he did. If it had not been for Joe Oliver, jazz would not be what it is today." This next one's called Tears.
You want to say some more so we can rest our jobs for a little
while? I can speak.
Oh, that worked out?
Yeah, because I have a question to the trumpet player. So, do you have a lute which is a king, which is a Louis?
For the two of us?
Uh-huh.
I'm playing the role of King Oliver more regular, just playing the melody lines and trying to be a little bit more predictable so that, I'll let Nathan speak to this a little bit, so that he can be a lot more creative and inventive, because I think Louis Armstrong is a lot more creative and inventive, but learned a lot of that blues language from Joe. Mm-hmm. I don't know, maybe.
Yeah, I mean, like, Louis filling in all the cracks on those recordings, and because it's a bunch of moving parts, what those cracks are different, so I'm not necessarily trying to play exactly what he was playing, and more so just try to fill the same role and fill up space and respond and double different instruments.
Double seven.
How about that, Zach and Nathan?
Yeah.
One, two, three, four. This next one's called the Riverside Blues. It's a good time to introduce the band, I think. James McClaskey on his banjo back here. Hunter Bergamy on the guitar. Dizzy Injerleolu on the washboard. Haruka Kakuchi on the trombone. Nathan Wolman on the trumpet. Zach Lang on the trumpet. Craig Flory on the clarinet. And I'm John Joyce on the big wood bass. This is another great song that they recorded. It's called the Riverside Blues. Thank you.
issues.
That was the alligator hop.
That's right. This one's called the Weatherbird Rag. right. Looks like we got two more songs left, everybody. Thank you so much for being here with us at the Jazz Museum. Wow. Real privilege and an honor. Thank you so much. This one's called The Frogamore Rag. It was written by Jelly Roll Morton and recorded by King Oliver and his Creole Jazz Band as well. Yeah, thank you so much, everybody. We got time enough for one more song. This one's called the Dippermouth Blues. Lots of these great songs are on our CDs, and they're over here. You can talk to us after the show. They're just 15 apiece or 20 for two different CDs. Play that thing.
Awesome. The Secret Six, everybody. The Secret Six.
Thank you so much, folks.
Round of applause. Awesome. And if you enjoyed this program, I know you did, please feel free to come up front and check out and buy their albums. And they also will have a performance at the French Quarter Festival. That's Friday, April 14th at 1:30, I believe. So please check them out. Come up for purchasing their albums.
11:30.
And again, if you are interested in NPS programs, check out nps.gov/jazz. Secret Six, everyone. Yeah.
Thank you so much, everybody.